nice and solid, and your tusks, and no movement. Perfect. Well, my friend, if I may call you that, you are nice and dried solid. It's been a whole week since we last saw each other, and now it is time, as promised, that I will paint you. I have it all planned out. I went and acquired a variety of different colors. Pink, purple, green, and I planned it out as you were drying here in this void. I put a lot of thought into which colors to use for all the different parts. Your hair, nice and carved out there. Your skin tone, your iris, maybe your sclera. The sclera in us humans is the white part of our eyes. I might color those. I might color your scleras a different color than your irises. A different color for your tentacles above the top color, and then the underneath color, and the color for your tusks, and your horns, your three horns, eye stalks, even the eyes of your eye stalks will get colored. You're going to be like the most beautiful sculpture and work of art when I'm through with you. Just all kinds of different colors. It's going to be fun. And all you have to do is remain where you are. It's not like you have any choice in the matter. You have no body. You're just a head, a bust. But maybe we'll sculpt the body for you, but that's another time. Okay, so why don't we go over? I'll just show you what I have. I have this. Measuring cup. It's an antique from another multiverse, a particular planet called Blurth, I think, or Mirth. I forget, something like that. And they used to use these quaint, primitive devices to hold liquids, and they would use measurements to determine how much liquid it could hold. So I like to collect antique primitives from faraway planets and ancient civilizations, and this is just one of many. But it makes a nice sound, I think. Maybe you'll like it, the sound of it, now that you have ears. Oh, your ears are nice and solid too. I forgot to check those. Yeah. Okay, no worries there. Okay, anyway. yourself because you're solid clay. But I think I catch a little bit of a glimmer. Some happiness, a little sparkle in your eyes. When I go like this, you feel how soft that is. Don't blink if you enjoyed that. Okay, you did enjoy that. Excellent. Okay. So, I'm not going to go through all the different colors, but I'll just go through each color as I go to paint different sections. Start with your eyes. I'm going to paint your irises black, of course. So here is the black. Load up my brush. there's the orange here. Not to get it mixed with the black of your pupils, but the black is already drying. That's the good thing about acrylics. They air dry fairly quickly. see the white there. Center of the palette. For now, I will be using this white for your tusks. Yeah, I'll put some more in one of the recessed holes. But for now, Scleras of your eye stalks. I know you're probably thinking like some kind of reptile, but there are many creatures throughout the multiverse, humanoid, non-humanoid, inanimate, that are green, so it's not specific to reptilian creatures. I can't think of any green creatures off the top of my head, but I know they're out there. So, green for your skin tone. And for that, I'm going to use this medium brush. Well, it's small. Small brush, but not as small as the one I was just using. So, gonna need quite a large amount of that. Okay. you can't see. And then we'll just go with the rest of your face. I might have to add a little light green, dark green, and different shades of green so you're not all the same color, but I'll do that. There, the area right here, and you do have a little bit of eyelid that I sculpted. Even though your eyes are open, underneath your cheek, side of your nose there, the wider brush to cover more of an area, but suction cups. They'll have to be a little darker just to show the detail. But let's do your eye stalks first. Could have stuck with a green, but I thought let's make your eyes stalks stand out a little more from your flesh tone. Okay. So we'll go pink. Asleep by that time. Okay, that's your right eye stalk. Do your left eye stalk. Eye stalk. I just love that word, or those words. Well, stalk, but eye stalk, two words. You don't hear that too often. And you may find this hard to believe, but I don't know too many humanoid-like organisms that have eye stalks. Most of my friends that have eye stalks are snails. And slugs. Some crustaceans. Okay, just touch up your eye stalks a little bit more. mostly painting the underside of your tentacle, of your tentacles. I was gonna ask if you've ever had anyone paint your tentacles before, especially the underside of your tentacles, but obviously I'm the first, so I'm quite honored to be able to have the pleasure of painting your tentacles. I think whenever you paint someone's tentacles, you should paint the underneath the tentacles first, and then paint the top of the tentacles. Yeah. Okay. So we got the pink. I think we're all done with the color pink. I have some notes, and my notes say underside of the tentacles and eye stalks. Again, I'll have to later on today, while you're passed out, fast asleep, I'll have to come around from the other side and paint where I can't get to right now. But that's it for the pink. Okay, so the top of your tentacles will be next. Rinse my brush and dry off my brush. And for the top outer portion of your tentacles, going with the color purple or violet. I like that word because of the consonants. Purple, 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 purple. You can even say it without pronouncing all the other letters. Get some purple onto my palette. Purple palette. Purple palette. Purple palette. Purple palette. I need a lot of that. My large brush, well, medium. There are much larger brushes, but in this context, compared to the other two brushes, this is large. Let's get that loaded up, some purple. Start with your left tentacle as it comes right out of the side of your face. Thank you. feels like to have your tentacles painted compared to your ears or your eye stalks, or does it all feel the same? vanilla, the off-white, for a more age type of bone color for your horns. And I might have to grab some yellow, but I don't have it here because I wasn't planning on using yellow to paint on you. But I may have to add some more tan or yellow to make it more aged looking. But for now, we'll go with that for your horns. So let's load up my brush. Maybe you can see a little bit off-white. And we'll start with your center horn. So that's the best I can do from this side. Looks good. And now for your left and right horns. Load up my brush. And we'll go with your right horn. Thank you. scales. I can't even tell if you're awake or asleep. And some bright red, fiery red paint for your scales. I may add a touch of orange to the scales, some gold to show some reflection, some shimmer, metallic-like nature to the scales instead of a flat red. But like I said earlier, that'll be another day or two. Just have to get the base coat. Okay. Alright, so that's it for your scales. Around your face. Okay. Now, let's see what I want to touch up. Let's touch up the eye stalks a little bit. Actually, let's touch up your eyes. Could use a little more orange. so.